following contest is scheduled for one fall and is a preview for the upcoming World X-Cup Tournament. Making their way to the ring, being led by Coach Scott Kimmore, representing Team Canada. They are the team of Petey Williams and Bobby Roode.
The countdown to the World X-Cup is on. 2 weeks and counting. Teams from the United States, Mexico, Japan, and yes, Canada, to fight for the cup in the one-night X-Division event. Last Wednesday, as we see Scott Kimmore waving the Canadian flag that's attached to the hockey stick. But think about what these two men, Petey Williams, right there, the team captain, his partner Bobby Roode, they opened the eyes of the wrestling world last Wednesday when their Team Canada squad won an incredible eight-man tag team matchup over Team NWA from the United States. What a match that was, Don, 1 week ago.
One of the best I've ever seen, and how impressive were the new members of Team Canada. I have to give it to them. What a good move by Scott Kimmore, bringing in Bobby Roode and bringing in Showtime Eric Young. What a combination they were.
Yeah, and then making this man the new captain, Petey Williams.
Oh, how impressive.
And their opponents, representing Team Mexico, they are the team of Heavy Metal and Hector Garza.
Well, you know what? Nobody told Jeremy Borash about Antonio Pena's move. Yes, originally scheduled as Hector Garza and Mr. Aguila, but we understand a substitution made by the AAA boss, Antonio Pena, putting Abismo Negro into the match with Hector Garza. I mean, my guess was it's to keep the other teams guessing.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, they didn't tell anybody. But that's what, originally it was Mr. Aguila. Then he changed it to Heavy Metal before today. And then right before the match, they changed it to Abismo Negro. That's the kind of, obviously Tony Pena was watching how good Team Canada was last week, and he wanted to keep them off balance.
And if,
smart thinking there by Tony
Pena. And if you think of this World X Cup, Don, it really is more about the team than it is the individuals. This one-night team concept event coming 2 weeks from tonight.
Boy, yeah, there's never been a tournament coming up like it is in 2 weeks where you're going to have to depend on your teammates. Everybody's going to have to help out in every which way, and it is going to be the ultimate in team sports. I'm going to tell you that right now as you see Hector Garza out there with Petey Williams in the ring.
Scott Kimmore, the TNA Canadian representative and the boss of Team Canada, looking on. Captain Hector Garza and Abismo Negro, two of the prime reasons behind the success of Team AAA. You know, I would almost think that you have to make the team from Mexico the favorites going into that World X Cup on May the 26th. They're undefeated.
Wow.
They've beaten Team NWA, Team Canada, Team UK.
Hey, until somebody takes your title, you're the champ, buddy. That's exactly the way you got to look at it. Every victory they got, the confidence level just grows and grows and grows. And they, you know what? They're so good. They become crowd favorites here in the United States. It's unbelievable, this team.
Don, I don't think you can deny, however, that the toughest test to date for Team AAA from Mexico is 2 weeks from tonight as we see one team captain, Hector Garza, take the other team captain from Team Canada, Petey Williams, just take him overhead and toss him to the mat.
You know, we talked about the good news about making Petey Williams team captain. Team AAA Mexico did the same thing, making it Hector Garza. This guy has been the MVP of Team AAA. He's been so impressive. Everybody talked about how good he is. As big as he is and then as agile as he is, this is going to be a great match right here. Oh, great blow there by Petey Williams. And look how quick Petey Williams is to get up to the top of the ropes. Oh, he caught him. And caught the Hurricane Rana perfectly. And takes Hector Garza over.
High risk off the top and high reward for Petey Williams. But as he plays to the crowd, he turns his back on Garza and he pays for it because Garza connects with the drop kick.
You know, if you're going to oppose to the crowd, you better make sure you finish the guy before you do it. He didn't do it that time. Hector Garza just got right up and went right after him. But oh, the momentum of Hector Garza took him out of the ring. And you see Petey Williams taking Abismo Negro down.
DDT
two.
Cover Garza in to make the save and break it up at two. Petey Williams tags in Bobby Roode, and when you talk about the changes that Scott Kimmore made to Team Canada, it's a bigger Team Canada. You might give up something in the high-risk offense, but at the same time, you have a bigger wrestler like a Bobby Roode.
Right.
Who can counter some of the other high-risk tactics of the other teams and ground them. I think it's pretty sound strategy.
It's great. And I'll tell you why. Look at these two standing in the ring together. Look at them. They're the same size. Hector Garza has always been bigger than everybody. Now you look at it. Now you know why Team Canada did it. You got to counter. And You see Hector Garza there trying to offer the hand in friendship. We've seen this before, but it's Bobby Roode.
I don't think Bobby Roode's seen it. He didn't see that kick either, directed with authority right to the back of the knee from Garza.
Well, Hector Garza being smart, knowing that Bobby Roode has never seen him in the ring here in TNA, so he used that to his advantage.
Tag in, and Abismo Negro follows up, repeated shots with the boot, reversed off into the corner, and Bobby Roode did not connect. Monkey flip attempt by Abismo Negro as he shoots Bobby Roode halfway across the ring.
He got that right. Great move by Abismo Negro. You know, this team AAA, all of the members, including Mr. Aguilar and Heavy Metal, and they just seem to get better and better every time we see them. They've really become a team, and oh, you can see Abismo Negro using a strength right there.
Quick double leg that time at the takedown by Abismo Negro forces Petey Williams, the team captain from Team Canada, to come in and make the save for his partner Bobby Roode.
How impressive was Petey Williams last week? I mean, this guy, a great member as a team captain. We keep talking about it. He just shows so much confidence out there, and he's fearless as he goes up high again. Look at his team.
Fearless? You called him fearless? Off the top. And he bulldogs, just drives Abismo Negro down face mask first to the mat. Follow-up knee drop by Roode. Parlay's hook cover, two count, Garza in for the save.
Just in time as Hector Garza realized how close that was. As Abismo Negro now making the quick tag, getting the two-on-one advantage. Oh, and they use it.
Those quick tags have really worked well for Team Triple A. Pin attempt by Abismo Negro. That time on Bobby Roode, not able to put him away. Garza and Williams, the two team captains, fight it out on one side. And they drive the two Canadians together. And then the double kick.
What teamwork right there as they took Bobby Roode, just kicked him inside out. Hector Garza's now got Petey Williams, and he's setting him up. Abismo Negro trying to set up Bobby Roode in this corner, and you can see Hector Garza coming over, and here they go.
Well, they double team. They shoot Roode right off into his own partner.
Oh!
What would you describe that?
I don't even want to try to describe it. I think picture's worth a thousand words right there.
The sudden stop, possibly?
A little humiliation to Petey Williams and Bobby Roode. Crowd, of course, likes it. As you can see now, look at that. As Abismo Negro just plants Bobby Roode. Can't quite get the pin.
Can't quite put him away. Team Canada, Team AAA, fighting it out in this four-man tag team match. Just a little bit of a preview of what you can expect 2 weeks from tonight, May the 26th, the first ever World X Cup. Garza now back in control. Brings out the arm, but then Bobby Roode stops him in his tracks. Vicious knee, follow up, series of boots to the back and to the back of the head.
Great counter there by Bobby Roode. He saw the opportunity, he saw the chance. He put that knee right into the stomach of Hector Garza and then followed up with a boot to the face, and now he's got the advantage.
Mid-ring shoulder block by Roode.
Oh, look at the strength of Bobby Roode.
Power slam, one, two, no!
Oh, that was impressive, Mike.
And again, you see the power, the strength of the larger Team Canada member, somebody like Bobby Roode, able to overpower Hector Garza. That's something we didn't see the first time when Mexico faced Canada.
You're right. I'll tell you something. I didn't like the way Team Canada got their victory last week. Nobody would after such a great match, but you got to like...
Oh, and again, the cheap shot from DeMore.
Just as I'm talking about it, I was going to talk about how good Team Canada really is. Then they don't need somebody like DeMore doing that, taking the cheap shot.
Yeah, I mean, think about it last week. DeMore leading the charges. The focus was all on the Team NWA captain, Jerry Lynn, and you see the cheap shot from DeMore? Who was it against? Team captain from Team AAA, Garza.
Good point.
Butterfly, double, underhook, overhead suplex, and the pin by Roode is broken up by Abismo Negro.
Well, if you cut the head off the snake, you got the advantage, and that's what they're trying to do. They're trying to go after the team captain and Hector Garza. Trying to injure him of some sort. Petey Williams now using his agility. See what he did? Look at that! What a move by Petey Williams.
Head scissors takeover by Williams. Shot up into the ropes by Abismo Negro. He takes it up.
And
Petey Williams, quick move! No.
Look how he was able to take that and just slow it down into the pin. Almost got it.
Abismo Negro, he was going to go for a pile driver there, tombstone style, but it was broken up by Williams, and then Garza comes in from behind.
Wow, Petey Williams, three straight times there, almost had this thing over with. Oh, Hector Garza, though, comes in and using the equalizer right there and kicks on the leg, and look at the blow right there to Petey Williams.
Big right hand, rocks Williams, shot off into the rope. Garza takes it, but Petey Williams comes back, answers with a deep arm drag that sends Garza to the floor. Williams going to fly. Measuring him, sets up.
He's caught him. Look at this. This guy's fearless, like I said. He doesn't matter about the signs. It doesn't matter about anything. He just goes right after him.
Slingshot into the Hurricane Rana by Williams. Rude was going to fly, I think, as well, but Abismo Negro cut him off. Over the shoulder of DeMore, you were looking from outside as Abismo Negro.
He's got it right here. One,
body
two. No, not in time. Oh, look at this. As Abismo Negro takes down Bobby Rude. Petey Williams and Garza
Wait
going
minute.
At it.
Hockey stick came into play right there. The distraction.
Oh, oh there oh. it is. Come on.
He just butt-ended
no,
him.
Come
he
on.
Butt-ended
One,
him with the
two,
hockey stick.
No.
And again, DeMore proves the difference.
The winners of the match, Team Canada.
He drove that the butt end of the wooden hockey stick right into the stomach of Abismo Negro.
Oh, he knew Petey Williams had the referee distracted with the action going on between Garza and Williams outside the ring. He stole the advantage and he took it. Scott DeMore stole this one for Team Canada.
For the second week in a row,
oh,
Scott
look at
DeMore.
Him posing.
And Garza's had it.
Oh, look and see that. Oh, he knows what happened there. Petey Williams and Bobby Roode come in for the beatdown.
And again, the double team now on Captain Hector Garza.
Well, Abismo Negro's hurt.
He Jerry Lynn.
All right, Jerry Lynn's in the ring. He saw what happened. He knows what happened last week.
Captain of Team NWA, the U.S.-based crew, Jerry Lynn comes out. And right in the face of DeMore, and who can blame Jerry Lynn after what went down last week?
Oh, Scott DeMore's headed out for Jerry Lynn from the beginning, trying to somehow find a way to get him out of this tournament. Oh, look at this. Look at this.
Yeah, all of a sudden, DeMore backs off. He takes the Team Canada jacket off like he's ready for a fight, but look at him bang off.
Oh, he doesn't want no part of Jerry Lynn without his boys in the ring. I'll tell you that right now.
Scott DeMore, the difference using the hockey stick.
DeMore!
Wait a minute.
You keep flapping that big fat mouth of yours about thinking I should be replaced as team captain? Well, I'll tell you what, like I told you before, at least I'm here in the trenches fighting alongside my men, not hiding behind them like you!
Amen!
You said a mouthful.
Yeah, you! And I dare you! No! I'm begging you! Just give me 5 minutes with your chubby butt! Come on!
What? Uh-oh. Challenging DeMore to a match?
He said he just wants 5 minutes with him. He won't need 5 minutes.
Jerry Lynn! You come out here in front of all your biased people! You want 5 minutes with me? You want 5 minutes with me?
Yes!
That's right, I want 5 minutes with you, and it won't even take 5 minutes! Hey, Lynn, you want 5 minutes with me? It's real simple. Next week, if you can beat Bobby Roode, I'll step in that ring for as many minutes as you want. I don't care who you stick in here. I'll tell you what. Right now, I will tear my way through a live side of beef to get my hands on you. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey, cut that music out. Hey, cut that music. Jerry Lynn, you want me. You want something. You put something up. Next week, if Bobby Roode beats you, when Bobby Roode beats you, you'll step down as the captain and a member of Team NWA.
What?
What do you think about that?
Oh, he's trying to.
Come on.
Boy, that's high stakes.
Oh. Talk about guts.
There's too much at stake. Jerry Lynn can't accept it. He can't accept it.
You're on.
What? He's putting up his position, his role with Team NWA next week.
That's how bad he wants Scott DeMore. That is how bad he wants him. He's willing to put it up
to get that 5 minutes with Scott DeMore. Wait a minute, then we got some chaos. There's chaos in the back. Something's 8-man tag team matchup over Team NWA from the United States. What a match that was, Don, 1 week ago.
One of the best I've ever seen. And how impressive were the new members of Team Canada. I have to give it to them. What a good move by Scott DeMore, bringing in Bobby Roode and bringing in Showtime Eric Young. What a combination they were.
Yeah, and then making this man the new captain, Petey Williams.
Oh, how impressive.
And their opponents, representing Team Mexico.
2 weeks and counting, teams from the United States, Mexico, Japan, and yes, Canada, to fight for the cup in the one-night X Division event. Last Wednesday, as we see Scott DeMore waving the Canadian flag that's attached to the hockey stick. But think about what these two men, Petey Williams, right there, the team captain, his partner Bobby Roode, they opened the eyes of the wrestling world last Wednesday when their Team Canada squad won an incredible. It's to keep the other teams guessing.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, they didn't tell anybody. But that's what, originally it was Mr. Aguilar. Then he changed it to heavy metal before today. And then right before the match, they changed it to Abismo Negro. That's the kind of, obviously Tony Pena was watching how good Team Canada was last week, and he wanted to keep them off balance.
And if,
smart thinking there by Tony
Pena. And if you think of this World X Cup, Don, it really is more about
how they are the team of heavy metal and Hector.
Nobody told Jeremy Borash about Antonio Pena's move. Yes, originally scheduled as Hector Garza and Mr. Aguilar, but we understand a substitution made by the AAA boss Antonio Pena, putting Abismo Negro into the match with Hector Garza. I mean, my guess was it's...
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is a preview for the upcoming World X Cup Tournament. Making their way to the ring, being led by Coach Scott Kimmore, representing Team Canada. They are the team of Petey Williams and Bobby Roode.
The countdown to the World X Cup is on.